2021 Honda Civic Type R Limited Edition Review, Yellow Gorgeous. But before we start, please support us by pressing the like and subscribe buttons, so that we can continue to provide information about car and motorcycle news. Also turn on the bell button to get the latest updates. Your support means a lot to us. Thank you. It's nearly time to say goodbye to the current Honda Civic Type R, which will cease production on July 31st when its manufacturing facility in Swindon, England, closes. It's fitting, then, that the automaker chose Phoenix Yellow for a limited run of 250 examples to commemorate the hot hatch. After the current Civic Type R flames out in glory, its replacement will rise from the ashes sometime next year. The unique hue also pays homage to Type R's from the past, including the first Civic Type R of 1998, Forbidden to Americans, and the US-bound 2001 Acura Integra Type R. Along with the heritage paint, the Type R Limited Edition wears a unique set of forged BBS wheels that reduce unsprung mass and require a slight retuning to the dampers and steering system. Finally, by ditching the rear window wiper, parcel shelf, and some sound deadening, the Type R lays lighter by just about 50 pounds relative to its more common siblings. And while the changes aren't really noticeable on public roads, the not-so-mellow yellow Civic is still a hoot to drive. Looking at the 2022 Honda Civic sedan and hatchback, it's pretty apparent that the automaker is correcting, possibly overcorrecting, for the current example's unhinged exterior styling. The Civic Type R is even more exuberant, with massive, fake grills on the front and rear bumpers, faux vents on the flared fenders, and a functional NACA duct on the hood. All that before we mention the huge, hatch-mounted rear wing and center exit exhaust, which for some reason exhales through three pipes. The Type R is not a vehicle for introverts. We'll forgive some of the exuberance, particularly in this particular color. Phoenix Yellow is one of the most recognizable hues in the Honda portfolio, and it looks resplendent on the Civic Type R's comically angry form. Adding to the appeal is impressive paint quality. If you told us this vehicle was hand-assembled next to the Acura NSX at the automaker's performance manufacturing center, we'd believe you. The matte black wheels, faux carbon fiber side skirts, and gloss black body accents with red pinstripes are a bit of a mishmash, but they also give the Type R an angry hornet motif that wholly suits the car's purpose. Inside, this is the same Honda Civic we've appreciated since its debut half a decade ago. The interior is attractive and well-constructed, although the hybrid digital analog gauge cluster looks dated by now. Red and black suede microfiber appears on the sporty front seats and thick rim steering wheel, although we wish the rear seats' plain black upholstery matched better. At least there are red seat belts for all four passengers to liven things up. The McDonald's approved color combination isn't subtle in the slightest, but we like it just the same. The current Civic Type R does an excellent job of balancing freeway comfort while remaining fun to drive. The biggest contributor on this front is an excellent set of well-shaped sport seats that keep you in place during sporty driving without pinching your backside the rest of the time. The shoulder bolsters, in particular, deserve praise. Positioned perfectly to keep your arms in a good relationship with the steering wheel and shifter, they make driving the sporty front driver much easier and more enjoyable. And in spite of those massive 20-inch wheels and a relatively short 106.3-inch wheelbase, the Civic Type R has a comfortable ride, easily the equal to the Hyundai Veloster, and truly broken pavement makes its presence known with a fair amount of harshness, but the hot hatch is poised over even marginally maintained roads. For as much grip and roll stiffness as the Type R has, its composure in daily driving is an impressive achievement. Of course, if you're after an even more polished ride, there's always the similarly priced Volkswagen Golf R. We wish the engine were similarly enjoyable, but unfortunately, it lets a lot of racket into the cabin. That would be forgivable in a performance car that sounded nice, but instead, the 2.0-liter turbo 4 under the hood emits noises akin to a vacuum cleaner fitted with an aftermarket muffler from the mid-2000s. We expected better from Honda, which has built some of the zingiest four cylinders in history. The 2021 Civic Type R's electronics and infotainment date back to 2015, so they're obviously pretty outclassed by other, more modern competition. The Hyundai Veloster N and forthcoming Golf R, for example, have software with crisper graphics and better ergonomics. At least Honda gave us back a proper volume knob and some hard buttons instead of useless capacitive touch sliders, though the 7.0-inch screen is still a bit slow to respond to inputs. Wired Apple CarPlay and Android Auto help offset the hopelessly outdated, though standard, embedded navigation, which comes to Honda by way of Garmin.
Thanks for watching. Drop a like, leave a comment, and don't forget to subscribe to watch more videos like this.